evening, I'm Keisha Butts with a CTV News update. COVID booster shots are now available in Prince George's. The County Health Department has started administering third doses of the Pfizer and Moderna vaccines to those with weakened immune systems. Byron Scott has her story.
Earlier this week, CVS stores began giving out the third dose of the Pfizer and Moderna vaccines. Today was the first day here at the Sports and Learning Center.
It is day one at the Sports and Learning Center for eligible people to get their third dose of the coronavirus vaccine.
We've had at least 8 to 9 people already early this morning.
The center is still administering first and second doses. The third shot is for those with a weakened immune system. Charlene Davis was here to get her third dose of Moderna.
I knew with my medical problems with the lung cancer and so forth that I needed to get up here as soon as possible to get this shot. Not only to protect me, but also to protect the people in my community.
Individuals seeking a third shot do not have to receive it at the same location as their first two. They just have to make sure it's been at least 28 days since their last inoculation.
That's the CDC guidance. It's 28 days, so that's the guidance we're looking for. And that's where the validation of the date for their last shot is critical. And then what dose did they receive. So if they received Pfizer, for their vaccination, we want to give them Pfizer as a booster, and same for Moderna.
Again, the only people authorized for a third shot are those with a weakened immune system.
What we're doing, bring them to that table first, that make sure we answer their questions, that they may, if they say, do I have this? They're not sure they have that condition. That nurse can help them. Make sure that they are, in fact, one of the ones who are designated to receive the third dose.
The Sports and Learning Center is open 7 days a week. The vaccinations are free and no appointments are necessary. In Landover, Byron Scott, CTV News.
The FDA has not yet authorized additional doses for the J&J vaccine. Here are the latest COVID-19 numbers. Of the 1,206 cases confirmed by the health department, 196 are here in Prince George's County. The county's positivity rate is at 6.79%. 6 people have died statewide from COVID since yesterday. 656 remain in the hospital. As hundreds of Afghan families begin starting over here in Maryland, a Prince George's group is stepping up by furnishing homes.
It's giving back to the community, and it's welcoming our new neighbors.
Homes Not Borders volunteer Ron Vandervoort is helping set up an apartment in Riverdale for an Afghan family.
I tend to get really focused when I'm working on a job, like trying to put this bunk bed or this crib together when I don't have instructions. And some of my friends that I work with kind of tend to pull me out of that and realize and see the bigger picture that we're really helping people.
Homes Not Borders works with refugee resettlement agencies by furnishing homes before families move in. The organization says it needs donations and volunteers.
They're coming here with next to nothing, and we've brought together all these items so that they can come here and at least have a home that's fully furnished and has all of the items they need to feel comfortable so that they can settle and hopefully, you know, find a job, feel safe, and thrive here.
I think it's a very worthy mission, helping people who have been dispossessed, shall we say, from their homeland. It must be an awfully horrible thing. And the more welcoming we can be, the better.
Executive Director Laura Osuri created the organization through her church.
We felt the need to provide them a nice, comfortable place to land when they resettle and make sure they don't pay for any of it.
Vandervoort says families are thankful.
Unfortunately, we don't get to meet a lot of them, but those that we have helped and actually that we've met, they've come back and helped us sometimes with that, and they're extremely appreciative and very grateful.
A family of 6, including 4 kids, will be living here. They're expected to move in next week.
In other news, a volunteer firefighter has been indicted on sex offense charges. The suspect is 53-year-old William Rodriguez Lott. He has been indicted on 2 counts of third-degree sex offense and 2 counts of fourth-degree sex offense. The suspect allegedly had sex with a 14-year-old back on July 14th. Rodriguez Lott served as a volunteer firefighter with the Chapel Oaks Station in Capitol Heights. Officials say the victim and suspect did not know each other. A spokesperson for the Prince George's Fire Department says Rodriguez Lott was removed from duties when the agency learned of the allegations. The morning commute was a torrential mess today as our area experienced inches of rain, putting us under a flash flood warning. This was a scene in Kettering. You can see the water above the banks of the creek. Some areas in the region reported downed trees, and in some jurisdictions, there were submerged cars. The flash flood warnings have been canceled across the region. Still, forecasters say flooding continues to be a possibility because the ground is saturated. You're watching CTV News. I'm Keisha Betts. We'll be back in a moment.
Every 2 minutes, a woman is diagnosed with breast cancer. With your help, we can end breast cancer. We are all stronger together.
Welcome back. The Dutch Market in Upper Marlboro has been fined for violating the county's mask mandate, responding to complaints that workers were defying the mask rule. The market has been fined $1,000. The business was warned during an unannounced inspection last week. The fine was imposed after a follow-up inspection. The governor announces a multi-million dollar initiative to expand rural broadband internet access. The Connect Maryland program will invest $100 million to expand internet access. Hogan will also create a bipartisan broadband work group to advise him on how to spend the new funding.
Today, through Connect Maryland, we are also launching a new emergency broadband benefit subsidy program to reduce the cost of internet service for low and moderate income households. And this program will combine state assistance with federal resources to give eligible Maryland families a discount of $65 per month for up to 12 months on their internet service to help us remove some of the barriers to broadband service and access.
Hogan says residents can apply to the program through the Department of Housing and Community Development. Police are looking for leads in a fatal shooting case in Upper Marlboro. Last Saturday night, 20-year-old Alexander Corman was shot in the 8300 block of Hollow Tree Lane. The Bethesda man was found wounded inside a car. Tonight, police are reporting that Corman died yesterday of his injuries. They're asking anyone with information on the case to call Crime Solvers at 1-866-411-TIPS. Police arrest a 14-year-old after a shooting at a basketball court in Germantown that left one man dead. Shailene Wiley has been charged with first degree and 3 counts of attempted murder. He's charged as an adult. The incident happened at Plumgar Community Center Wednesday night. 3 juveniles were also wounded in the shooting. M&T Bank commits $1 million to provide loans to small businesses in Prince George's County. The funds would go to those that would not typically qualify for loans, with a focus on women, minority, and veteran-owned businesses. M&T is the 11th bank to join FSC First, an organization that provides funding for small businesses through a variety of loan products.
These loans typically range from $50,000 to $250,000. And actually, they can be used for any legitimate business purpose. We realize that many of our local businesses have been severely impacted by COVID-19. So this program is also designed to play very nicely with some of the grant dollars that we've already administered to businesses in Prince George's County. This program is designed to be very innovative and creative. We can extend the loan term. We can be flexible with the interest rate.
For more information on the loans, go to fscfirst.com. The jobless rate falls slightly in Maryland. The U.S. Labor Department says it fell to 6% in July, down from 6.2% in June. By comparison, the D.C. rate was 6.7%. In Virginia, it was 4.2%. And still to come, Terps football and much, much more. Stay with us.
The sooner you recognize the signs of autism, the sooner you can make a lifetime of difference for your child. Start by answering a few simple questions at screenforautism.org.
Thank you for staying with us. School systems across the nation are facing a shortage of school bus drivers, an ongoing problem that has been exacerbated by the pandemic. In Delaware, parents are being offered a $700 voucher to pick up and drop off their kids. Others are delaying the return to classrooms. Locally in Montgomery County, new buses are being delayed due to a lack of computer chips for AC units, as well as a shortage of drivers. AAA Mid-Atlantic says the problem is going to substantially increase traffic across the region as more parents drive their kids to school.
We suffer from the third or fourth worst traffic in the country. And if school buses were taken out of the equation, or if parents drove their kids to school, which almost 60% of students have their parents drive them to school now, you can just imagine what would happen to our transportation system. It would just be paralyzed, especially around schools. And that would make school zones inherently more unsafe and riskier for students because of the chaos that would ensue. And you can imagine all the traffic backups and the tie-ups and the traffic delays because we didn't have enough school bus drivers.
Prince George's students return to the classroom on September 8th. Montgomery County schools go back to school on August 30th. The Prince George's Police Department is looking for a few good men and women. If you want to serve, your community officials ask that you consider a career in law enforcement. A number of officers are set to retire, and the agency wants to fill their positions. To apply, you must be a U.S. citizen, have a high school diploma, and a valid driver's license.
If you want to be a part of the community and be a part of a larger family, and if you want to be a part of the change that you want to see, we're looking for you. Individuals that like dealing with the community, dealing with people and talking, and want to solve problems and want to help. So those are the types of individuals that we're looking for.
It's football night in the DMV. The Washington football team will host the Cincinnati Bengals at FedEx Field tonight. The field may be a bit soggy, but the teams will kick off at 8 p.m. It's game two of the preseason. Meantime, the Maryland Terps are 2 weeks into training camp for the upcoming season. As they get ready for their second team scrimmage tomorrow, head coach Mike Locksley says he's seeing good progress.
You know what, I've been really pleased with where we are with camp. Been a competitiveness that I hadn't seen since I've been here. And, you know, obviously we've increased our depth. We've increased our talent level, which allows that to happen. As I like to say, you start seeing the player-driven culture really surface, especially when you have hot days like today. And we've been able to, you know, get out and really have to work through some of the weather adversity. We've had a rain day. We've had some really hot days. And I like the way that they've responded collectively.
I feel as though we're expecting to play fast. We're expecting to be very hungry and to play with extreme effort every play. I think we carry a chip on our shoulder. We carry around a little mantra like no BCEs. I think we go about that every day. And everything we do, we carry around, we go about our business and we work hard. With the skill, with the talent, with Coach Stu, with the staff, with all the coaches, I feel as though we're going to be in a position that we could be a very good defense this year.
It's moving forward toward our goal, which is to, you know, put a team out on the field September 4th that knows what to do and will do it with the right kind of discipline and handle the type of adversity that will happen during a game the right way.
The Terps began the 2021 season against West Virginia on September 4th. Let's get a quick check on our three-day weather forecast. Tonight, isolated showers and thunderstorms with a low around 70. Saturday, partly sunny with a chance of showers and a high near 85. Sunday, mostly sunny with a high near 88. Monday, mostly sunny with a high near 91. And now for the community calendar, attention parents. Join school board members and public school administrators for an informative back-to-school community meeting. Learn more information about virtual learning, how to use School Max, transportation, and more. The virtual event takes place August 23rd from 6:30 to 7:30 p.m. Participants can join using the Zoom link on your screen. For more information, call 301-952-6115. And that wraps up our CTV News update. I'm Keisha Butts. Have a good weekend.